Hello my dears, welcome back. In the previous class we studied about energy and completed one of the mechanical energy, that is kinetic energy. And today we are going to learn more about potential energy, the second type of mechanical energy. So do you know what is potential energy? So let's learn. So here you can see a figure. In this figure you can see a boy is lifting a book from the ground. Is in work to be done to lift the bodies? The answer is yes. Can you say against which force is work done here? Here the work is done against the gravitational force. The second one, here you can see three different heights of the object having mass m. The heights are h1, h2, h3. Can you say at which height from the floor is maximum work done on the body? Yes, it is at h3. If so, in which position does the body get the maximum energy? Let's see. When height from the floor increases, energy also increases. So here the answer is at h3. The work done against the force of gravity to raise a body is preserved as excess energy in the body. So, the energy increases as the height increases. The energy possessed by a body by virtue of its position is the potential energy. So what is potential energy? The energy possessed by a body by virtue of its position is the potential energy. And the equation for finding potential energy, U equals mass into acceleration due to gravity into height, that is U equals mgh. So let's see some examples of potential energy. We studied that potential energy is the energy that possessed by virtue of its position. So every object which is in a height possesses potential energy. For example, coconut in a coconut tree, water stored in a tank at a height, a cyclist or a stone at the top of a hill, etc. possess potential energy at a height or position. When the height varies, the potential energy also varies. Here you can see two situations. A coconut falls down from a coconut tree. Water is pumped to an overhead tank at a height. These two are examples for potential energy due to position. And by analyzing these two situations, we can say that both the situations possess different heights. And here the potential energy varies according to the height. Next one, do bodies get potential energy due to their position alone? Let's have a look in this figure. You can see a spring with a wooden block here. When the spring is compressed or elongated, it gets the ability to do work on the wooden block. Aren't we doing work on the spring when a spring is compressed or elongated? The answer is yes, we are doing work here. And this work helps to change its shape. The work we have done on the spring to change its shape would remain in its as its energy. This energy is called the potential energy due to strain. So what is potential energy due to strain? It is the work we have done on the spring or any object like this to change its shape would remain in it as its energy, and this energy is called potential energy due to strain. Some examples for potential energy due to strain are a stretched bow, a rubber band in stretched position, compressed air, etc. So students, today we have studied about two types of potential energy due to position and potential energy due to strain. I hope you all understood this topic. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video.